Hello to all of you. So in this lecture we discuss about sewage system. So waste water generation scenario in India city and its treatment. Most of you are aware about that. How much amount of water treat in our India. Like in India, the estimated sewage of generation from class 1 cities and class 2 towns, which is representing 72% of urban population, is 38,524 MLD of their existing treatment capacity of only 11,787 MLD. Means this is about 30% of that particular facility which are provided for the retreatment or treat of the wastewater. Here, the major 35 metropolitan area have a collective sewage treatment capacity of just over 50%, but high variability exists among them. Only 5 metro cities have a treatment capacity close to the 100. Here, there are Hyderabad, Baroda, Chennai, Ludhiana, and our Ahmedabad. And Delhi has the largest sewage treatment capacity in absolute term, but it is only 60% it's needed. Here, as well as Mumbai. Mumbai has the second largest treatment capacity in absolute terms of 80%. Clear? So this is the scenario in our India. So there are two types of challenges in wastewater treatment. Where? On-site challenges, off-site challenges. Clear? So there are two types of challenges, on-site and off-site challenges. So the conventional engineered wastewater treatment system is extremely expensive, very costly, that treatment process, and the initial cost is very high, and it requires various complex operations and maintenance cost in expanding sewer networks. So that particular water treatment process and water treatment structures are very costly, and as well as operational cost and maintenance cost is also high. So the total capital cost of establishing collections and treatment system for the entire urban waste water generated is much more than the government plan to spend. So as a result, progress in increasing coverage is likely to be slow in the foreseeable future. The second one, off-site challenges. Analysis exhibits the macro factor such as the FTA, that called a free trade agreement, cost sensitivity, varied climate and interest considerations differently impact operation in India. So there exists immense opportunity for foreign companies owing to, there are two reasons. First one, commercially viable, advanced technology. Then second one, environmentally conforming solution. So there are two challenges, off-site and on-site challenges. In on-site challenges, there are cost. Off-site challenges, there are macro factors like FTA, cost sensitivity, varied climate, and different types of operations in India. So what is the necessity of wastewater treatment, or what are the needs for wastewater treatment? Wastewater contains different types of substance like organic and inorganic, which is dissolved in water, and it also includes toxic elements such as cadmium, zinc, copper, chromium, arsenic, mercury, lead, etc. Clear? So these are the various toxic elements which are included or dissolved in this water. Disposal of the water directly into the water bodies like a river and ocean may affect the marine life, or we can say that aquatic animal life. This is the reason why wastewater treatment is required. Then after sewer network, the present Indian scenario. The proper sewerage system includes collections of sewage from source of generation through sewer network treatment using appropriate available economic technology to the prescribed disposal standards and state disposal to natural water bodies. दैट सीवरेज सिस्टम इंक्लूड्स सीवेज ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सोर्स लाइक शिवर नेटवर्क लाइक हाउसेस डन सो दैट सीवरेज सिस्टम इंक्लूड्स दिस टाइप ऑफ सोर्स. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ सिस्टम available in general for waste water collections and disposal. So first one that called separate system, second one that called combined system. So in separate system, sewage and storm water are collected separately and sewage is treated for safe disposal. Then second one, combined system. So the following are in combined system, sewage and storm water are combined and treat for the safe disposal. So there are the some drawbacks or challenges or disadvantages faced due to lack of proper sanitation facility. So first one, population affected with the issue and ultimately affecting GDP of the country. The second one, the ground and surface water source are being polluted, hence water supplies became costly and inadequate. Clear? Due to that sewage system, the groundwater and surface water are polluted and the GDP of the country also decreased. So there are some major reasons for inadequate sewer networks or sanitation facilities are followed. First one, insufficient fund, and the second one, improper design approach and management of sewer networks. So there are the two reasons for inadequate sewer networks. There are some IoT based smart wastewater management system. So first one, preventing CSOs, so combined sewage overflow. So that by the IoT sensor, which are capable to detect combined sewage overflows. So when that particular sewage overflow, so that sensor warn that particular agency or municipality, and also you get a real time notification as soon as the sewage water or sewage water overflows. During rainwater resulting in overflow of combined sewer system in poor waste water management system. Clear? So this is a preventing combined sewage overflow. So by using IoT sensor, so you can aware or the sensor warn about that or get real-time notifications. Then second one, tracing chemical detections. So IoT can play a significant, means important role to detect chemicals in water pipelines. With the non-IoT wastewater management system, research would have to detect chemical levels water manually. So by IoT sensor, we get different types of substance formations within a minute. And IoT also send alerts to remote dashboard. Then third one, replacing leaky pipes. So a leak in distribution pipe that distribute water regionally can result in heavy loss of water. So by the IoT sensor, you can collect the data or type of sand that pipe rests on, the topography and what weather records. And then AI can help to analyze the data and find the patterns that offer the clue, the water utility about which pipes are at a risk of leaking. So by the IoT sensor and AI, you can check the pipes leakage or the capacity or sustainability of pipe. Then fourth one, select waste treatment process. So different types of substance or different type of constituents require different type of treatment process for remove. Clear? So the advanced analytic feature of IoT can recommend a series of choose process based on the concentrations of water. So there are some advantages of using smart water, wastewater system. Real-time data integrations. Second one, enhancing customer satisfaction. Third one, accurate forecasting of demand. So how can you get real-time data integration? By IoT sensor. Clear? Then second one, enhancing customer satisfaction. So you can supply water with than demand. And third one, accurate forecasting of demand. So by different surveys, by different technologies, you can forecast the population, and according to that, you supply the water to that population. The next topic is flood management. You, everyone aware about that, what is the meaning of flood? Clear. So flood management is, in our India, India is highly vulnerable as most of the geographical area is prone to be annual flooding. Clear. In some area, in monsoon, they are prone to annual flooding. Clear. Due to that, losses or high damages occur due to flood. So there are there is a need for integrated flood management. So there are some plans which is required. First one, disaster preparedness plan. So in disaster preparedness plans, a flood management plan is needed to include disaster preparedness. This may require different types of actions. So first one, flood hotspot mapping at a local and regional scale. So by that flood hotspot mapping, you aware about in which time or in which duration the flood will occur. Then second one, management and regulations of riparian zones to prevent spilling and erosion. So by the municipality, by the government, they repair the different types of zones which are prone to be eroded or prone to be spilling. Then after, river flood modeling to prepare for incidents like river breach, means failures of river or overflow of river and emergency water release from dams. So river flood modeling indicate which area is prone to be danger while flooding or while releasing water from the dam. Advanced techniques such as a mapping based on satellite imagery and GIS will help the development of flood in early warning systems. Then second one, integrated approach. In integrated approach, there are steps need to be taken for watershed management through the integrated approach. Watershed management means catchment that particular area. The hard solution is that it involves civil engineering construction such like as a dam, culverts, dikes, widening and deepening of river channels and diversion channels to store and divert water to increase the lag time of reaching downstream. So there are different types of structures required to mitigate the flood action. Then ecological soft solution. There are soft solutions like that, restorations and management of riparian zones of forests along the river channel with the lead to retention of rainwater and reduce the river discharge. So these are the soft solution as well as the hard solution in integrated approach. Then third one, prioritize buffer flexibility and adaptability. So this is include reviewing system, reviewing safety and criteria of dams as well as canals, and rebuilding these with the higher safety factor, creating new intermediate storage. Then fourth one, reducing disaster risk reduction. So there is a need of efficient implementations of Sendai framework disaster reduction. This will reduce the vulnerability of any disaster. So there are some reasons of flooding in all the major river system. First one, obviously intense rainfall. Then second one, topography of the catchment. The third one, sedimentations of river and reservoir. Fourth one, obstructions in the river flow. Fifth, failure of dam, failure of river embankment. Seventh one, inadequate cross drainage work. Eighth one, concentrations of waterway. Clear? As a you civil engineer, so you already aware about that particular causes. So you can describe in deeply, clear, what is the meaning of that particular reason. So these are the some descriptions of that particular causes: intense rainfall, topography. Yeah. So there are other causes of dam failure: that piping, erosion, foundation failure, and also earthquake. So what are the ill effects of floods? So that each effect of flood classified into particular three groups. First one, inundations of low-lying area. Second, erosions of river bank. Third one, change of river course. So what is the meaning of inundation of low-lying area? Means the low-lying area means the low area which is below the ground level. You can say that as compared to other area. So that area prone to be danger or they fill with water. Excessive runoff, inadequate channel capacity, presence of obstruction in the streams, inadequate water due to rail, road, canal crossing, congestions of confluences, tide resisting flood flows. So there are the reasons of inundations of low-lying area. The second one, erosion of river bank. So in river, the discharge or the velocity of water during flood is very high, so current will be high. So it away the banks, so means the bank will be eroded due to that particular velocity and discharge. So that affect the stretches and also stretches of agriculture land. Then third one, change of river course. So the river course, the change of in the river course of the river may develop due to following reason. First one, due to high velocity, due to abrupt variations in bad gradient and heavy sediment charge. Then third one, due to escalatory bed of the river flood damage. So there are the three ill effects of floods. Then next one, flood damages. Again, the flood damages divide into two groups or classified into two groups, direct and indirect damage. In direct damage, due to physical contact with water, like erosions of agricultural land, loss of human life, any animals, loss of property, and then after breach of roads, canal, pond, loss of forest and wildlife, then breach of road. Clear? Then second one, indirect damage. So indirect damage, the water does not come into direct contact of the property, but cause the damage of interruptions and other causes, like labor is put out of the employment or work due to submergence of factory. School and colleges remains closed for few days due to flood, due to interruptions of transport service, business industries affected. So this is the indirect damage. So again, there are two types of flood damage, direct and indirect damage. The next one, flood alleviations or flood mitigation, or we can say that flood control. So how can you reduce the flood effect? So flood control is also known as a flood management. So in India, about 40 MHA of land is flood prone, which is about 12% of the total geographical area of 321 MHA. So there are two types of measures to mitigate the flood disaster. First one, structure mitigation measure. Then second one, non-structure mitigation measure. So in first one, structure mitigation measure, so we can construct storage reservoir, levees, flood walls, channel improvement work to floodways, sluices, diversion headworks, constructions of high earth platform. And in non-structural mitigation measure, the flood plain zoning are required. So that means dividing the entire flood area into different types of zone and restrict the occupancy of different zones of the flood plain to use which will suffer little or no damage due to flood. So what are the objective of flood zoning? Flood zoning means to divide that particular area, that called flood zoning. Or what are the objectives? So first one, to restrict encroachment of the zone which frequently comes under the influence of flood. The second one, to direct selected activities in the zone which come under the influence of flood less frequently in such manner that susceptible or to flood damage. Then third one, to demarcate the zone which are subjected to flood only to rare occasions. So there are the objectives of flood zoning. The next one, flood forecasting and warning. So by the forecasting, so we can aware about that particular that flood will be come here or the disaster will occur. Then so by that forecasting and warning, so we aware and we prepared for that situation. So flood forecasting in morning, it could be conveyed earlier. So disaster due to the probable flood can be minimized to a great extent. So in monsoon, there are some particular weather forecast, weather forecasting, our government say that in some area, so there will be flood come. So by that, we mitigate or we minimize that particular action or disaster. The temporary evacuations of person and shifting the important property to safe place could be done before the flood arrives. So in India, 7 flood forecasting units have been operating at New Delhi, Guwahati, Jalpaiguri, Patna, Bhubaneswar, Surat and Lucknow. So there are 7 places which are used for flood forecasting. So forecasting of flood magnitudes is evaluated by the following method. First one, rainfall runoff relationship, unit hydrograph, synthetic hydrograph, state discharge relationship. These are all are you studied in hydrology. Clear? Then third one, emergency evacuations of area. Clear? In this, emergency evacuation means emergency emergency conditions. The people can evacuate from that particular area, means low-lying area. These areas do not justify other expensive method of flood control. So loss of life can be prevented by the emergency evacuations. And fourth one, management of floodplain. So the floodplain of river is formed by sediment deposition, means silt. There are one type of soil. Means soil depositions or removal, which usually occurs due to intermittent overflows of the stream above the. There are various types of tool of flood management, RS, like flood hazard survey, then second flood plain zoning, flood proofing, flood insurance. The last one, flood proofing. So it is a combination of structural change and emergency action. So structural change includes constructions of buildings wall with some waterproofing material and closure of level windows, constructions of the house with arrangement of stilts. These are the methods by we can mitigate the flood. Clear? Then in next lecture we discuss about flood forecasting and warning in India. Thank you.